This is Confessions of a Shoeholic, and I am your host, Rafi Avir. Collectors, collections, one world, one idea.
I got a million ways to get it.
So, Mr. Antonio, what makes you a unique collector?
Well, I think what makes me unique is the variety of collections that I have. I just don't stay at one kind of genre of shoes, like, you know, not just basketball shoes, like Jordan or Kobe, LeBron, KD. I go from running shoes, classic running shoes. I go for classic brands such as Asics, On Super Tiger, Adidas, Puma, Vans, Reebok, you know, and like Fila as well. Everything that I see that I like, if I really like them, I'll buy it. Doesn't really matter how much they cost. So, yeah.
Next question. How do you feel whenever you purchase a pair of shoes?
Before, it probably took a while for me to like put down a pair of shoes. Whenever I purchase a shoe, I open the box, you know, look at it for a while. Sometimes I would even smell it, you know, and I'd take pictures of it, you know, post it on Facebook groups, share it with other collectors. That was me before, as a newbie collector, you know. Even the cheapest of, you know, of sneakers that I bought, I remember that I'd post like 17 pairs of shoes that I bought in a day from different vendors, from different resellers and from retail stores for one day, and you know, just put them in one display, everything I bought for a day, you know, from the car going to my storage.
Person regarding pathological shoe collecting, could you tell us a better way to understand it?
Now, if you're going to look into the behavior of a pathological shoe collector, so it has, you have to consider several facets of the pathology, of the term itself. So let's start first with pathological. Pathological meaning it's a disorder, or it's abnormal, or it's not within the norm. So in psychiatry, when we talk about something, when we talk about disorder, it means it already affects the normal functioning of the individual. Okay. Now, of course, shoe is one of our basic needs, and then collection, meaning you have this tendency to accumulate certain objects, here particularly shoes.
Lastly, what is your opinion regarding the pathological shoe collecting?
Because your term, as I've mentioned earlier, is pathological, it means a disorder. So I've read on shoe obsession disorder, where some people say there's really no disorder into it, or there's no there's nothing abnormal to it, because, you know, all of us would need shoes. But to certain extent, it becomes pathological when you collect things beyond your means, and it already affects your normal functioning. Like, you tend to have abnormal behaviors, or particularly antisocial behaviors, just to satisfy your urge or need for collecting shoes.
So here's our last shoeholic, Mr. Gab Ganlas.
Hey, what's up, Rafi? How you doing?
I'm all good, man. So
okay.
So for you, what makes you a shoeholic?
Well, what makes me a shoeholic is I collect a lot of shoes. I have a good number of LeBrons in my LeBron's in my closet, as well as some other styles, the Air Force Ones, you know, the classics, the Nike Dunks, and then other shoe brands as well, like Creative Rex, Timberlands, and so on and so forth. So I've been collecting since high school. I started off again with the basics, the Air Force Ones, the Nike SB Dunks, and the normal Dunks. And then till recently, I've gone to the more mainstream high-end brands like the LeBrons. I have a KD, but they're mostly LeBron, so not really much of a Jordan fan. But yeah, I have a lot of them. That's what makes me a shoeholic.
So, for you, how are you different from the other collections out there?
I can say I'm different from the other collections because most people have Air Jordans in their collection. If their collection, most if not all their collection is actually Air Jordans, so the ones, the twos, the threes, four, fives, to the 12s, so the 14s maybe, because those are the, you know, all of those shoes Jordan wore during his playing days. So that's what makes me different. Everyone else has Jordans. They probably have LeBrons here and there. I mostly have LeBrons in my collection because the history of the shoe is more important. The story of it is more important to me. Growing up, I never watched Michael Jordan. He wasn't exactly my favorite player growing up. I was watching Shaquille O'Neal, so I had the Shaq shoes from Payless in the U.S. I also watched Karl Malone, so I never really got the Karl Malone shoes. Who else did I do? Chris Webber, the Dada, the C-Dubs. Never got my hands on those, but they never came out here, so those are just some of the, you know, some of the ideas that my ideology towards shoe collecting. The history of the shoe has to be there, it's the story of it. I mean, it's not just, oh, just because someone else has Jordans, I'm going to start collecting Jordans too. That's not my thing. I'm more of what I want to collect, I want to collect. The story is, you know, the story is important to me too. Well, it's actually pretty hard being a shoe collector. There are certain things you have to think about. Of course, you got to think about your budget. Shoes nowadays, you know, run you a lot of money. You know, it's not really easy to, you know, to have money in your hands. So one thing you got to think about is your budget. Especially with the newer shoes nowadays, like for example, these Bron 10s ran me about $9,000. If you buy this at the reseller, they'll probably cost you more. The LeBron 9s went for about $8,200. So in today's shoe game, it's actually pretty hard to get the shoes that you want because they're mostly high-end shoes and, you know, they're priced ridiculously. Maybe because of the materials and, you know, the labor and stuff, but and the patent. But everything else, you know, it's pretty expensive. And then, of course, you got to think about the availability of the shoe. Number one, in your size. I'm a size 11, so it's a very common shoe. It's a very common shoe size here. So a lot of, you know, the styles that I want often go out of stock just like that. And then, of course, one thing you have to think about is also the hype. Because, you know, like these, for instance, these came out last year, and these were gone in less than an hour.